Hi, and welcome to the practical video. Today we're going to show how you can run LLM evaluations with no code. Here's what we're going to do. We will generate synthetic data. We will run evaluations using deterministic methods, and then we will create a custom LLM as a judge. To follow along, you will need an Evidently Cloud account. It is free to sign up. Optionally, you will also need an OpenAI API key. It will be required to generate synthetic data or to run LLM as a judge. If you don't have a key, don't worry, you can still run evaluations that don't require it. Let's start with a quick intro about us. At Evidently AI, we build tools for AI observability. They help you evaluate, test, and monitor AI systems. We support both traditional machine learning models and systems built with LLMs. Our roots are in open source. We created Evidently, which is a Python library with over 25 million downloads. It helps you run tests and evaluations for all kinds of AI systems. Evidently Cloud is a platform built on top of it. You can use it to run AI quality workflows from pre-production experiments to production monitoring. It is also built for collaboration. Developers can use the Python API and non-technical users can walk through the user interface. You can see how your app performs and run evaluations with no code. That's what we're going to do now. The first step is to sign up for Evidently Cloud. Once you are in, you will need to create a project. Click here and give a name and description to your project. I already have a project here, so I'm just gonna open it up. It will be empty at first. The next thing you should do, if you plan to use LLM as a judge, is to go here to the secrets and save your OpenAI API key. I already have one, so I'm just gonna use the key I already stored. Now, let's generate some data. Go to the datasets and click on Generate Dataset. You can choose between two options. We will gonna try both. Let's start with a simpler one that says examples. What happens here is you can just generate a set of plausible inputs by describing your task scenario. For example, let's say that we are dealing with a health and fitness chatbot. You can add a description of your task here. An example input could be something like, how much water should I drink daily? And let's say you want to generate 10 more questions like this. And also let's save the name of the dataset like QA. Clicking Next, you will need to choose the API key, and now you can generate the dataset. Here it is, so let's take a look. If you open it up, you can now see that there are more similar questions like how often should I work out, how do you create a balanced meal plan, and so on, which are realistic inputs that can be asked if you are building an app like this. You can edit and diversify these inputs further. Remember, these are just the inputs. You'd use them, for example, to run through your LLM system to get responses. Now let's try the second option. We're gonna go back to the datasets and click on Generate Dataset again and choose the knowledge base option. Here we generate both the inputs and the outputs from the source document to get the ground truth dataset. You can take a PDF, CSV, or Markdown file as a source. I suggest you try something short to make the generation quick. As an example, I have here a PDF with the European AI Act that I will use as a source. You can simply drop this document here and give it a name. And let's say I want to generate 10 questions to this document. Here we got the final result. So let's open it up. On the background, the platform processed the document, extracted the context, and generated questions to it. Since the answers come directly from the trusted source, we can expect them to be reliable. You can, of course, manually review or tweak them if needed. Later, you can take just the question part, pass it through your system to generate answers, and compare those answers to the ground truth. Now, let's talk about evaluations. If you did not generate any data, I prepared a simple example for you, which is a CSV dataset with questions and answers about health and fitness. You can simply download it and then work with it later. Let's go back to the datasets tab and now create a new dataset from CSV. we need to give it a name. So it will be, for example, health chatbot. The description is optional. And then we can drop this CSV that we have. We will also need to map the columns, which simply means that we need to point to the columns that contain text data. Here it is. So now the dataset is uploaded and saved on the Evidently platform. You can see that now we have both questions and answers to the question, something that you could have generated with your LLM chatbot. To run an evaluation, let's go to this evaluation tab. You can choose the dataset. This is the dataset that we just uploaded. And now we need to confirm and run the evaluations. Here, you will need to choose the text evals. And now we can point to the column that we want to evaluate. Let's look at the answers that we get. You can choose from different evaluation methods. Let's do something simple at first. For example, we might want to check if there are any denials, meaning if the LLM declines the response. This is an LLM-based classifier with a pre-built evaluation prompt. Let's choose this one. Also, let's look at the semantic similarity. We can compare our answers against the question and measure the semantic similarity between them. This can be useful, for example, to detect the answers which are completely irrelevant and are not semantically related to the question. Then let's also look to the text length. If you do not have an OpenAI API key to run LLM as a judge, we can do something simpler to detect denials in text. We can use regular expressions and, for example, define if there are certain words which are representative of a denial. To do this, we can choose this contains descriptor. Let's give it a name, denials, regular expression. What we need to add here is a list of words or expressions that might be representative of denial. For example, this can be something like sorry, cannot, and apologies. This is not a complete list, and obviously you can add many more examples like this. It doesn't have to be case sensitive. So here we are. We defined our report. We choose our key to use LLM as a judge evaluations, and now we can run it. And here is the result we get. At first, you will see a report which summarizes all the evaluations that we had. So the decline evaluation was the LLM judged denial. We can see that we have one decline. If we look at semantic similarity, we can see that all of the values are above 0.78, which means that none of them is completely irrelevant or unrelated. This is good. Then if we look at the text length, we can actually notice that we have one answer which is unusually long, might be interesting to check out. And our regular expression-based denial also noted one denial. So let's check it out. And below you can see the data set with the scores that were added. You can actually hide the report if you're no longer interested in looking at it. So now let's take a look at what we got. First, we can find the one denial that we got using the LLM as a judge approach. And we can see that this is, well, an actual denial, and the LLM declined to respond because the question was related to medication. Probably that is a good one, right? So we don't want to give medical advice here. And this is the explanation of the denial that was given by the LLM judge. Finally, we can find the response that was too long. We can see what happened here, that for some reason we actually got the response that was unusually long and almost looks like it was copied from some document. Might be something worth checking out. Interestingly, if we look at our regex-based denial, we can find the one that was true. It actually detected correctly the same denial that LLM as a judge did, because it actually had the words that we defined as a representative of denial. In this case, it says, I cannot provide specific answer. But of course, this regular expression-based evaluation will not generalize as well as LLM judge. Now, as I look at these responses, I notice that they actually have different tone. Some of them are more formal, some of them are less formal. Let's try to see if we can detect difference in tone using LLM as a judge. Let's go back to our evaluation. Now we will run a single evaluation using LLM as a judge that we will create for this specific reason. Again, we're going to choose the same data set that we are working with, confirm the column mapping, and choose the text evaluation flow on the answers that we get. But now what we're going to pick is the custom LLM classifier. You can see here examples of the other checks that were already implemented when you're using a pre-built template, but now we're going to do a custom one. So let's choose none. Let's say that we will call this tone, and now we need to explain what exactly we want to classify. Here I came up with a very naive prompt, which basically explains that we want to classify the responses into conversational and formal. The conversational response is something that is friendly and uses casual language, and formal is a structured, objective response that only focuses on conveying the information. So I should also specify the names of my categories. So this will be conversational and formal. You can see that I didn't write the complete prompt. Actually, this happens automatically. The full prompt is being generated, asking for things like explanation and how to structure the response. Now, I saved my LLM judge. I'm choosing the key, and let's now run the evaluation. Here it is. So as we can see, the responses are being split almost half-half. 7 of them are labeled as formal, 6 are labeled as conversational. Now we can look at the specific decisions that were made by the LLM judge. We can see that it actually picks up pretty well. For example, here it picks up that it uses phrases like hey and snacky, which is kind of conversational, or totally get it, mix things up, and so on. If we scroll down, we can see more formal responses, and we can see that, well, they are truly formal. They are more to the point, and the LLM judge picks this up and explains that the text is structured, professional, and so on. Now, as a reminder, it's best to first do your own labeling so that you can compare your evals against them. What we are doing is just a quick illustration. I hope it gave you some idea on how you can run evaluations for your AI outputs. And if you have any questions, please do reach out. Thanks for watching.